Gold Coast Service Paradise. We're at the end of Cavill Avenue, and here for some media stuff for Carrie Hart's Freestyle Hart and Huntington tour. Just carrying on, you know, getting all mons about it. You got Steve Vinny, Johanna Reed, Chainsaw, the Chainsaw, JT, the FC, and yeah, Mr. Hart himself.
So you're here on HH TV. This is a little clip of my Australia tour. Basically, I did a tour with my wife, Pink. Freestyle motocross show. Tons of fans here.
Look at this damn water out of here.
Dude, they're kicking ass, man. We teamed up with Holden and Rockstar and a handful of other sponsors and Hart and Huntington, and came up with this concept to do a free show, free to the public.
We just went to a lot of the city councils and see if we could get permits to places we wouldn't normally be allowed to do freestyle motocross.
We all wanted to do something a little different.
I didn't really want to get back into kind of promoting something else. I want to do my own thing. So I kind of sat down with my manager. We were like, all right, well, let's take all the elements of things in the life that I like. You have different art going on, whether it's tattooed influence or graffiti art. You also got a bunch of hot rods here, motorcycles. So the whole idea is a lifestyle event.
Yeah, it's basically the best you can get, paying nothing and getting the best.
A totally different kind of scene from our other shows, like our motorbike expos and stuff to do with Krusty and that.
To come back out here to Australia and just see how really passionate and how the fans really are thankful for us coming out here and put on this tour. I mean, it was all the value in the world to me.
Everyone's making phone calls, how much for a ticket? Well, there ain't no ticket, it's for free.
Yeah, nearly there, mate, nearly there.
Buy a ticket, you
know.
Look
at those guys, it's a free show and they're sitting on the fence thinking they're killing it. Sign your name on the line, here the devil's making deals. The devil's making deals, the devil's making deals. Money feed your family, money pay your rent. The devil's making deals, the devil's making deals. No sorry, why come?
This trip's been amazing. I've had so much fun out here. I couldn't even imagine it's gonna be this much fun. There's like a really good community of riders out here. Like they all help each other, and you know, you come ride at my place, I'll go ride at your place, and it reminds me of how freestyle motocross was, you know, back in the late 90s in America.
Beanie was some of the best athletes in the country and the world, you know, on tour in one go. So it's really good.
You have people that go to Pink shows who line up at 10 a.m. to get their spot in line, you know, to get in for her show when doors are at 6 o'clock at night. Well, this is something for her fans and something for my fans. You know, we did this free show to where her fans might know who I am, but they don't know exactly what I do. You know, we've been getting about 6,000 people per show, and I think that if we can turn some of her fans into freestyle motocross or just motocross fans in general, I think we're kind of coming out of this thing pretty solid. Amazing what these guys are doing on a bike now. I mean, it really is. Like, I couldn't imagine being a 19, 20-year-old kid being like, all right, I'm gonna get into freestyle motocross. I gotta learn every variation on a motorcycle, and then I have to learn that same variation in a flip, and I need to learn 360s, and it's getting pretty intense.
You know, that's the sport, it's always gonna evolve.
It's pretty cutthroat right now. You know, you gotta be on your A game, and you gotta be prepared to take, you know, serious risks. I mean, you always had to. But it's a pretty fine line now with the amount of different tricks that are out and the progression that's going on.
We were all, you know, like myself and Mike Jones and Brian Deegan and Metzger, we were all, you know, the rejects of Supercross. You know, none of us were really getting any love.
Like the rebel movement of motocross, so to speak.
Things have definitely changed, but in the early days, you weren't rich if you raced motocross. You were that white trash kid, and your dad probably had a big hot rod at home, and you had your dirt bike in the garage. I mean, that's how I grew up.
Now, the culture of freestyle is a big business.
To kind of see how there's like a resurgence of all this, you know, with how fashion is meeting, you know, hot rod culture and motorcycle culture, it's kind of cool to see like how all the dots are kind of starting to connect slowly over time, because it wasn't that way years ago.
Max Dolly's in the car park, bro.